Hey, how's it going, guys? Good? Thank you so much for being here today. My name is Duc Hoang. I'm a food blogger, part-time food blogger, full-time social media photographer. And 4 years ago, I started the page. I didn't think I was gonna like do anything. I thought it was gonna be just a hobby, but turned out it ended up being one of my career, my job as of now. And it's crazy, man. Like, I don't know how to start, but I remember the first time I opened my food page, my friend was just kind of like asking me, like, why, like, what are you doing? Like, you don't want to take food photos. Like, what are you doing? So I just kind of like got really shy. I didn't tell anyone about what I was doing. Almost like kind of shy myself away from that as much as possible. I didn't tell my friends until like I got to like 5K. I was just like, you know, I'm gonna tell them now. I think it's like a decent number. And yeah, first time when I started food, I didn't have enough content to post anything. It was just me going out to eat with my family. At that time, I was working 2 jobs. I was paying for all my school. Luckily, I didn't have to pay for any loan or debt like that. And just kind of pushing content every day is crazy because every day I was posting 1 picture per day at a new restaurant. For 2 years in a row, I was doing that. And I was kind of going broke, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I spent like $500 every 2 weeks or so. And I'm just like, I need to stop. So, hey, I'm not really. All my money went to food, pretty much, yeah. So I thought of an idea, which is like, how can I make money to pay for the food? How can I make money to start doing this daily? So what I did was I reached out to all the restaurant. I pitched to them, which is like 3 years ago, it's not that common. Nowadays, it's more common for a restaurant to pitch out to food blogger to come out and try the new food. But 3 years ago, I would have to email them or like just kind of slide into the DM, just be like, hey, you guys want to like just count the food and I'll just talk about the food? And that's just the way it works. So soon after 2 years, I think 2 years, when I got to around like 30K follower, that's when people just kind of start reaching out to me. I didn't have to reach out to anyone anymore, which is good. So that's how I kind of got the free food, just anyone wondering. But I don't go to all the free food stuff. I want to go to the place that I want to go to. So I still spend around like $400, $500 every 2 weeks or so, which is not recommendable. Where do I start, man? I was an accounting major. I was an accounting major, yeah. On my last year, I switched to marketing. Last year, I had 4 classes left until I graduated from accounting, and I decided I don't want to do this anymore. So I told my dad, I was like, you know what? I don't think I'm going to be doing this forever. And he just looked at me like, oh, shit. Like, you know, one of those things that your parents is kind of like, they're not sad, more like disappointed. And I kind of felt really pressure because I didn't know what I was doing. Like 3 years ago, I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't know what I wanted to do. I was pretty lost. I go to school every day, just like everyone else. I finish all my work, my homework. I do okay on the test. Like, I was passing by, but at the end of the day, I wasn't doing anything great or anything like that. So that was one of the struggles, just kind of confronted with my parents, not having enough money to pay for the food. And the last part that I want to talk about is a lot of people have 2 plans, like plan A and plan B, right? So you have one thing that you're doing right now that you maybe you don't like that much, but you're just kind of doing for the money. And then you have plan B, which is like something you really love doing, but it's not your career, it's just your hobby. I would advise you guys to kind of dip your toe into whatever you want to do with plan B first. Which is why I did, which is I just, when I make the food page, it was my decision within two hours. I was in bed at 2 a.m. in the morning. I was just like, you know what? I just want to make a food page. And I did it within 2 hours. I did it. within 1 year later, it just blew up. So a lot of things can happen overnight, or like even within a few months or a year. You don't really know until you kind of try. So that's my advice for you guys.
All right, let's give one more round of applause for Duc here. And let's go ahead and get started, so.
I wanted to know, how did you build a following and how did you get people to pay attention to you?
When you talk about like just how to get more follower, are you talking about like technical or just like visually? So visually you have to make sure your content is good. You have to provide something that's different than like other influencer or bloggers. And then I think the third one is just being like very engaged, like talk to, pretty much be responsive to like any comments, any questions. If there was something going on, like if there's a trend going on somewhere, you want to jump into that and just kind of want to talk about it so that you're always in that loop. And then if we talk just about Instagram, then like I think reposting, if you get reposted by like other big pages, then I think that's the best way to get like follower. So like if you're a food blogger or any kind of blogger, when you post something, make sure you look up what account do repost and then just tag them into your picture. Yeah, that's what I would recommend.
I'm Alexander, and I had a question. What was the hardest struggle you had running the page?
Running the page?
Yes.
I would say, I think just how to make content, like how to make content looks good, how to keep doing that over the years is really hard. Because I know within 3 months, I almost kind of gave up because, like I say, like without having like the budget to go out and eat, you can't really just, unless you're really rich, and then you can't really just have that money to go out to eat.
Hi, my name is Amy. And I just wanted to know, how do you maintain relationships with restaurants or business owners?
One way to kind of maintain that relationship, at least personally for me, I can't recommend this for everyone else, but I like to talk about value more than just money. When a restaurant reaches out to me and they want to collaborate, I don't usually talk about money or anything like that first. I talk about what I can help them to bring exposure to the restaurant. How can I bring people to try the food? And a lot of the time, it's just a very simple kindness, which is kind of ask them how they're doing. It's just like, don't talk about work for a second, and I think it goes a long way.
Hello, my name is Philip. I have a very simple question. What is your favorite place to eat in Chinatown?
Ooh, I knew this was coming. Ooh. Ah, man. My go-to place is a Foo Foo restaurant.
Oh.
You know, it opened until like, what, 3 a.m.?
Yeah.
So like when you drink, you just kind of go there. Because that's like the only place that opened. The food is good though. Food is really good. But yeah, that's my go-to place.
Awesome. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Jensel. And my question is going to be, are you ever pressured to like give a certain review or give at least a lukewarm review to these places that you go to? Because I mean, how does it feel to like have these places bring you out and then like you can't really be 100% honest?
That's a really good question. So 2 years ago when I used to get invited by restaurant, it's almost like they don't force you to post anything, but it's like you have to post. It's just like you have to. And a lot of the time, like you, I don't know if you guys, if any of you guys follow me, but I would be like, oh, it's decent. But then it's like, you're like, oh, don't go here. Just like put a wink, don't go here. So I sort of kind of make that decision for myself, which is I don't go to any place now that I don't think the food is good. Or I'll let them know in advance, which is you can invite me out, but if I don't like the food and I don't think it's recommendable, I'm not going to post it. And so that's how I kind of went about being truly honest to like what I'm posting now.
What's up, man? My name is Tang. Just a like really like free question, but so I know you eat a lot like every day. You post every day. How often do you work out? Have you gained any weight since you started the page at all?
Oh, okay. So I think I gained 15 pounds like within like the last 2 years.
Uh-huh.
I used to play a lot of sport. I play soccer like 24/7. But Since I started doing the food page 4 years ago, I stopped working out, which is like really bad. Because man, like I do want to give advice on this too, but 3 months ago, when I went and checked up with the doctor, my health wasn't good because not working out, not exercising wasn't good for me. Even though I was really fit and I was like really athletic, but after like three or four years, like all the food started catching up to you. So like if anyone want to do food blogging, you have to like exercise for sure. Yeah.
One last question, this is the final question. What's your biggest piece of advice to everyone out here in the audience tonight in terms of helping pave their path forward in whatever it is that they want to do? And like you said, it requires balance and everything. So what's your biggest advice for that?
I think this is like really cliche, but embrace your culture, embrace yourself as who you are. Because like I feel like not until you embrace yourself, you have that extra energy, extra positive push that like will, you know, help you through the way. I feel like a lot of people just kind of like, if their friends or peers are like, you know, around them or like pressure in them in a different way, they sort of kind of shy away from who they are as a person. So just embrace yourself, like, just do whatever you like, yeah, pretty much.
All right, everyone, let's give one more round of applause for Duc. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
For being here tonight. Thank you.
Thank you.